could be in here.
Oh. Who are you? Oh, whoever you are, you must flee this place at once. He's killed everyone else who has come into this place. Almost. Oh, please, run!
Okay. Who you're talking about is this? Is that an ogre? Or ogrelon or something? How could a monster such as you? Why would I say that? A foul creature such as yourself? Why am I say- Is that? Who's talking? And who are you talking about? Who's killed everyone? Kala! Oh, I don't know what he's done exactly or how, but everything here is an illusion. But it's magic that can hurt you, if you believe in it. Well, you probably don't understand, do you? I don't know what he's done to the tent or with the others who have come in, but their deaths are real. You must run. Okay, so that's what's speaking. I thought it was somebody else. And that this one was attacking her. Just who are you? How is it a monster has the voice of a young woman? I'm not a monster. I'm an elf. A winged elf. Or at least I was. This covering you see is some kind of illusion, but if you believe in it, then it becomes real. Please believe me. Now go before something happens to you. I beg of you. Who is behind all of this? Who has killed everyone? Oh, Kala, yeah. I'm not going anywhere until I get a full explanation. Oh, I hope you don't end up like the others. But alright. My name is Aerie. I work in the circus with my uncle, Quail. I don't know exactly what happened, but everything changed a few days ago. Everything became chaos and turned into what you see here. Although it all isn't real, it's an illusion. The minions, they all say they serve Kala, so I know he's behind all of this. He's an illusionist in the circus, but I don't understand how he was able to do all of this. He's a genie, unless the genie's name was Kala, or the genie was just talking about Kala. He must be stopped before he hurts any more people. Please, if you release me from my chains, I can help you stop him. Chains? I don't see any chains on you. The chains are invisible, covered by the illusion, and they are magical. They prevent me from casting my own spells, and they maintain the illusion which is placed on me. Why can I not just dispel the illusions here? I don't know. I tried earlier, when this first happened. Kala's spells are too powerful somehow. He's never been that good, though, so I don't know what he's done. If you free me, though, together we can find out and stop him, and hopefully rescue my uncle, Quail. How do I release you, then? You need the key to these chains, but it won't look like a key. There are a couple of commoners in the north side of this chamber. Don't be fooled by the illusion, though. They are monsters. They have a sword which is actually my key. If you get it from them, I can remove the chain and regain my normal form. But please be careful. You can't trust anything you see here. Ugh. Investigate the circus tent. Yeah, I've agreed to acquire a sword from dangerous illusionary peasants in order to free a winged elf from the illusion that binds her. Yeah, it is her.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
You haven't found the sword? Oh, please, hurry! The peasants who have it are on the north side of the chamber, but they aren't what they seem!
Is that one of them? Pleasure slave? Alright.
Minsk bat kicking, for goodness!
I am ready.
I don't have a lot of healing left.
Every hamster
you require
has
my counsel.
His death.
But I can't see sleeping in this place.
Armored, sharpened and raring to go. Boo says, what? Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
All right, so if she's for real... those are the peasants. All right, let's talk to the slave girl. Well, that goes somewhere. Unless that's an illusion and it goes nowhere.
I am here to serve.
Please, welcome, lady, to Kala's realm. Be thee not of impure mind, for surely Lord Kala will destroy thee. Be thee not of impure heart, or thou wilt surely destroy thyself. Kala is the one ruler, the one true being. Who exactly is Kala, and where is this realm of his that I have come to? Kala is beyond thy ken, mortal. He is the beginning. He is the end. He is our god and our king. Tremble before him, and he may take pity on thee. I am my own person, and not this Kala's possession. Bow before the will of thy betters, mortal. Kala's rage is awesome to behold. Let not thyself be found in its path. Where can I find Kala? Worry not, for Kala has already found thee. Continue on thy path, and if thee should find favor in Kala's eyes, then thou shalt surely be granted an audience. Okay.
You point jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Okay, we've got a phase spider called Hannah.
Woman.
But please don't hurt me. Oh, what am I to do? What exactly is going on here? Oh, I don't know. All I know is I came into the tent to watch the performance. A gnome came on the stage and began to perform some kind of magical act. Do you have a son named... I forget his name. It was quite silly. It was obvious that whatever the gnome was trying to do wasn't working. His magic fizzled, and everyone started laughing. I thought it was part of the act, so I laughed too. And then everything began changing. People started transforming into creatures, and then back into themselves. The world shifted somehow, and I felt so sick and horrified. I think I passed out. When I woke up, I had been turned into this monstrosity. I don't know what to do. My son didn't come into the tent with me, and I'm frightened to think what may have happened to him. Sun is still outside. Well, we can't get to him. We have to find another way out. Who are these peasants here? They're not people. They're vicious and dangerous. I've seen them kill people. You must stop them. I'll try. Tell me, do you know where this Kala is? No, I don't. But that woman over there seems to know something about him. Perhaps if you talk to her... I think your son is still outside the tent. Wait here. He is? Oh, I will. Oh, thank you. I have found the mother of the boy outside the tent. Now I must see if I can restore her to her original form, along with the rest of this mad circus. Okay, these things are killers.
Sword! Live by the sword! Live a good long time!
Whoop! He took crushing damage from her. Has nothing to say. Alright, then we're attacking them.
Your life shall be mine.
A werewolf? Looks like a werewolf.
What is it?
Minsk and Boos.
Those of no confidence.
A scroll.
I have had to drop what you get. I have only two arms and no more space.
What?
Every hamster has his day.
Now for this one. Okay, so I guess this is the sword that's a key. An ogre with a woman's voice has asked for this sword, claiming that it will break the illusion cast over her. Otherwise, it's just a normal 2d4 longsword.
Where shall I display my skill in it? I must apologize, but I can carry no more. I have set your item upon the ground.
Yeah, we need room. Oh! Her stuff is here. His Imuin stuff. This is the Gloves of Missile Snaring. Oh, what do I have? Bracers of Defense.
I have too much in my pack as it is. You'll have to pick that up off the ground.
Oh god, you have to pick that up off the ground. Jeez. It's running out of bullets. Yeah, all her stuff's been carried over. I'm gonna drop some of these mundane items they've been carrying around forever. She has a helmet. Can you wear a helmet? No. For whatever reason, yeah. I guess bounty hunters can't. It is a bolt plus one. Okay. Keep the rest.
It is above time. Vita Mortis Cardio.
Armored, sharp, stand back for justice.
Alright, let's talk to her. We might have to try to rest here.
You haven't found the sword? Oh, please, hurry. The peasants who have it are on the north side of the chamber, but they aren't what they seem. You haven't found the sword? Oh, please, hurry. The peasants who have it are on the north side of the chamber, but they aren't what they seem.
Who says what?
Oh, that's not the sword. Wait a second. Here, I thought I just gave it to him. Someone has it. Oh, did I put it down? Did it look like a normal sword? I put down a bunch of weapons. Maybe the name changed once I picked it up.
The bigger they are, the harder I hit.
Oh, I did. Oh, I never picked it up because everything was full, and then I dropped everything and forgot to pick it up. Okay.
You have the key. Or rather, the sword. Please give it to me, and I can be rid of this illusionary form at last.
Not so fast. How much will you give me for it? What? All I have, which is almost nothing. Please, I will do whatever I can for you, but I can do nothing until you give me the key and I am free from my chains. All right, very well. I shall trust you and give you the sword. I thank you for your trust. This sword, it is actually a key that unlocks the chain that powers my horrible illusion.
My hands! My skin! It's real again! Oh, thank you, Baelvar.
Who?
I must find Quail and stop Kala before he does any more harm.
Okay. She's pretty interesting looking. Faerûn, is that your deity of choice? You must find Quail and stop Kala. We don't have a choice about going further into this place or not. Join with us and we will search for him together in this place. You would let me join you? All right. Come, let's find Quail. Who knows what they've done to him? You should be aware, perhaps, that I am hunting a very powerful mage named Arrhenicus. It will, no doubt, be a dangerous task. Oh, I would be glad to help you. Truly I would. But we simply must help Uncle Quail first. We must. Oh, he's an Uncle Quail. And she levels up.
Yes?
She is a cleric / mage. There's a standard quarterstaff and sling. A few bullets. And studded leather armor, which she's not wearing. Instead, she's wearing a traveler's robe. Wizard spells disabled. Alright, let's not disable the wizard spells. And then she has very low strength and constitution, but dexterity is 17, intelligence and wisdom both 16, charisma is 14. Faerûn. Cleric and mage level 6. I'm about to level up though. Okay. 0 hours with party. When asked about her past, Aerie becomes silent for a time, obviously saddened by the memory. She lived amongst the Avariel, the winged elves. Cool. And was captured by slavers when she was still very young. She shudders when she speaks of her first years in the circus, on display in a cage that restricted her movements to the point that her wings atrophied. They became infected, and Aerie can barely speak of the night she was taken out of her cage and her wings were sawn off brutally to keep her alive. That's horrible. She was no longer of use to that circus, and were it not for the kindness of Quail, she surely would have died. Oh, so he's not actually her uncle? She's like, you know, people call a friend an older friend, like aunt or uncle, I guess. He restored her to health and gave her a reason to continue living, and out of respect for his generosity, she learned the devotion of the gnomish god Baerûn Wild Wanderer. Okay, that's the name she invoked before. She speaks of Baerûn with affection, yet still pays tribute to Airdrie Fania, and approaches life outside of the circus with a combination of wide-eyed innocence and wonder mixed with an inborn determination to fight against injustice. Seems of a like mind. Okay, let's level up. Deco reduce, death saving throws reduced 2, polymorph reduced by 1, Thaco reduced by 2. She's got priest spells and a bunch of mage spells. 13 more hit points, lore increased by 12. Okay. Well, she's already proficient in mace, quarterstaff, and sling. So we could add in Flail and Morningstar. Why not? So she's a mage and a cleric. Identify magic missile, color spray, protection from evil. Alright, we're gonna get rid of that and that. Charm person. Magic missiles. Okay, here we have power word sleep. Oh, that's interesting. And stinking cloud. We could also throw in blur, detect invisibility, and Melf's acid arrow. And here we have protection from normal missiles and slow. She knows lightning bolt, minor spell deflection, remove magic. I'm gonna learn her some more spells, actually. We might keep her, maybe. Fire shield, improved invisibility, minor glove of invulnerability, and stone skin. And then level 5 spell she knows is domination. Hold monster, minor spell turning, shadow door, and spell immunity. She knows improved haste and contingency, but doesn't have slots to memorize them. Improved haste. The affected creature functions at double its normal movement and attack rates and receive a +2 bonus to its initiative. 3 rounds per... I wonder how this is improved. Thus, a creature moving at 6 and attacking once per round would move at 12 and attack twice per round. Spell casting and spell effects are not sped up. It seems like they are, though. Doesn't it look like they are when you cast the spells quicker? There are 3 major differences between the 3rd wizard spell haste and this spell. First, there is no period of fatigue following the expiration of the spell. I don't remember that happening with regular haste. And second, this spell will only affect one creature. Third, this spell actually doubles the number of attacks per round of the hasted creature. Spell also negates the effects of a slow spell, but is not cumulative with itself or with other similar magic. Its effects will last for the duration until dispelled. And contingency... I think I read about that in the manual. These are new spells. Permanent until triggered. Upon casting this spell, the wizard is allowed to choose a spell out of her repertoire of known spells. One spell level every 3 levels of the caster is allowed, up to 6 level spells at 18th level. Once the spell is chosen, the caster may choose a condition of some kind from the list provided. The starting condition can be anything from reaching 10% of her hit points to an enemy being sighted. Once the starting condition is satisfied, the spell that was chosen will be cast automatically. For example, a 12th level wizard could place the spell Stone Skin in a contingency, with the starting condition being the wizard reaches 50% of her hit points. Once the wizard is reduced to 50% of her hit points or below, Stone Skin will be immediately cast upon her. That's pretty cool. This requires no action by the wizard, but happens automatically and instantaneously. That's pretty sweet. Unfortunately, we can't know it yet. Oh, and then she's also got... priest, cleric spells. So we've got Bless, Cure Light Wounds, 2 of them, Doom, I'm gonna take out Doom, Sanctuary, I'm gonna take out Sanctuary, I'm gonna use that stuff. I mean, I could, and I probably will someday. Detect Evil, Magical Stone, Let's do Doom just in case, actually, after all. Okay, a lot of Care Light wounds. Aid. Box camp. What does she know now? Chant is good. I like chant. Hold person. Resist fire and cold. Silence, 15-foot radius. I like these spells. Slow poison. Yeah, I approve. Spiritual hammer. What's that one we have? No alignment. And hold person. Flame blade. Find traps. Bark skin. Chant. Draw upon holy might. Alright. So, these are the good ones. I am going to put another slow poison, actually. And here we've got cure medium wounds and holy smite. Any evil creatures within the spell's area of effect, which is a 15-foot radius, take 1d4 points of damage per level of the caster, or half damage upon a successful saving throw. If they fail, they're also blinded for one round. I like that. Of course, we're sacrificing a slot that could be used for cure medium wounds. Animate dead, cure disease, glyph of warning, holy yeah, that one. Invisibility purge. Well, we have C and Viz on the mage side. Miscast magic is always good. But we don't have a lot of slots here. Remove paralysis. Yeah, I need to put another for moderate. And then here is probably going to be two serious wounds. Let me see, we have Cloak of Fear, Cause Serious, Animal Summoning 1, Death Ward, Defensive Harmony, Farsight, Free Action. Always good. Holy Power. Oh, yeah, I'm not going to have it stride in like that. Lesser Restoration. Oh, we might want that. Especially for the we found some shadows in here. Negative plane protection. Only one creature, though. Neutralize poison. Protection from evil, 10-foot radius. We only have two things. I have to take that out and go look that. We can only know one of these. That was something to cause critical wounds. Probably going to be cure critical, I'm taking. Chaotic commands. Magic resistance. Cure command. Flame strike. Flame strike is good. Mass cure. Raise dead. Repulse undead. Righteous magic. True seeing. Or slay living. If I had two slots, I would do cure critical and raise dead. Dead, but wow. Okay. That was a lot of work. For just her. Oh, wizard spells are not disabled, right?
I'll help however I can.
Are they all mixed in? You're slow. Oh, jump to mage spells. Oh, that's cool. Okay. I like that. Much as I hate to do it, I think we need to rest in this place, though.
It is nice to have a woman in charge for a change. Men always steal the blankets.
Huh. Women can steal the blankets too, you know. Aye, but you didn't. Haha, this is going to be a good day. I can already feel it. I'm glad you feel that way. Unfortunately, we still have the task at hand. Anyway, I'm going to call in an episode here. Thanks so much for watching, guys.
Swords, not words!
More words. So stay tuned for the next episode when we go through this, which may or may not be an illusion. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.